Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. I just want to say a quick prayer this morning before I go into this prophetic word that I received from the Holy Spirit this morning. One thing that I can tell you for sure, over the past several years, the Lord has said, warn them, but also speak of my love, also tell them of my love. And many times, as you probably all are, I've gotten weary and I've waved the white flag and I've wanted to say, is that enough? Have I done my job? And the Holy Spirit said, even the rocks will cry out if you do not speak. So I just want to say that I love you all, and I promise Jesus I will not quit. Because I love him and he loves us so much. So I just ask, Lord Jesus Christ, that you come today to bless my brothers and sisters in Christ and bless me and my children and my family. Lord Jesus Christ, you are the great physician. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Your Father in heaven gave you power over the heavens and the earth. And I just praise your holy name, Lord Jesus Christ. And I ask you to please heal anything that is broken in us. And I ask you to forgive me of my sins. I repent of my sins every single day, Father. I fall short of the glory of God. Please forgive me. Take me from crimson white, red to white as snow. I plead the blood of Jesus over anyone watching this video, over this video, over my channel, and I glorify God. Let me never boast of anything of myself. As a matter of fact, I always ask, Lord, to please make me invisible and make you visible, Jesus. God bless them all, Father, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So this morning, the Holy Spirit put upon my heart to speak of repentance, which I put out a video on that, but also to stand on his promises, which I would like to do another video on that later on. But I was praying later on after I left my prayer closet, and the Holy Spirit started to speak to me. So I wrote it down. I will try to put the words in the drop-down box. My sister in Christ, Miss Cindy Rose, is kind enough to do that for me when I am either limited on time or have forgotten. So forgive me. I'm horrible at videos. I apologize. I'm just trying to be obedient to Jesus. So here we go. The Holy Spirit spoke to me and he said, stand firm in your faith and do not run from the trials. For you know that I, your God, will encamp my angels around you from all sides. You will be tested and tried for my name's sake. And for the kingdom of God, refined in the fire and made shiny anew for the day of my coming. If it were not so, my Father wouldn't have sent me to save you from the beginning of time. I was ordained to serve a divine purpose, which I fulfilled on the cross until my Father called me home. Now your transgressions and sins have been washed and sealed in my blood, the blood of my suffering, but you will also be glorified by the trying of your faith for my glory. Be transparent in your faith, being a bold witness for my life through your testimony. Do not worry for your lives or what man can take away or destroy. Fear more what the Father can do to your soul, for no one wants to end up in the lake of fire. The fear of God is a joyous noise. Bow down, humbling yourselves before him. In due time, you will be counted worthy to stand before him. Yes, count it all joy for the suffering you receive for my name's sake. The kingdom of God is at hand. Trust and see the goodness of God. Remove fear, unforgiveness, hatred, and strife. Put on joy, hope, and faith. Seek first my kingdom. And the keys to eternal salvation are yours. Be constant in prayer, never cease praying, giving praises and glorifying God in all things. Do not fear the wickedness that is rising. Put your faith and trust in me at all times. I came so that all may be saved. I came for the sick and the sinner. I came to bless, not to curse. I came to love, not to spread hatred. Follow in my ways of love and humility. Put on, therefore, the raiments of humility and love. Seek my face in these trying times. I have never left you. My love is of purity and gentleness. Do not let the cares of the world destroy what I have put inside of you, your purpose to be fulfilled at the predestined hour. Lean not on your own understanding. Trust in me. Your time is not my time. The realms are not the same. I am of the spiritual realm. You are of the earthly realm. Be not discouraged, but leave unto God what is of God, and leave unto man what is of man. Tarry not in the past. Set yourselves free of it. It only drags you down like an anchor with its weight, making you impossible for the present time of my countenance. I am here for the calling. Many have become despondent, sorrowful, lost. Do you not know that I control all things, that I have been given the power over the heavens and the earth? Do you not believe that I will take care of you? I long to give you joy and peace. I long to set you free, to give you the needs and desires of your hearts. I love you, my children. Seek my face, seek my heart. Know that you are being divinely guided. My time is nigh. Let it go. Any unforgiveness or sin that is holding you back from all that I wish to give you. I am a good father who has kept his eyes on every child. I long for that day that I see your faces standing before me, shining and glorified, no longer lying in your sackcloth amongst the ashes of sadness and sin, but glorified, tested, and tried. Be resilient, stay strong. The battle that comes against you now will not compare to the glory that you will receive the day I wrap my loving arms around you and embrace your sweet face. Sorry, that makes me cry. Know that I have loved you from the beginning. Oh, forgive me. Know that I am the only perfect being. Humble yourselves before me until that time, my time. Then, alas, you shall run free and celebrate at the banquet table. And I prayed and I asked Jesus through the Holy Spirit to give me scripture to confirm this. I always test the spirits and I always ask for scripture because God will not go against his word. And he gave me Psalm 62:11. One thing God has spoken, two things I have heard. Power belongs to you, God. And then I added 12, and with you, Lord, is unfailing love, and you reward everyone according to what they have done. I pray this blesses you today. I know that I have been through it, and I know that many of you are going through it also. But we have to, and here's a wonderful bookmarker to share with you, Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, I will give you rest. Don't we serve a sovereign God? Don't we serve a wonderful Father? Jesus is a father to the fatherless, and the Holy Spirit truly is my best friend. I pray this blesses you today. I pray that Jesus come and breathe peace into your life, restoration and peace. And all that is broken inside of you, I ask that he restore it, body, mind, soul, and spirit. Amen. Glory be to God. Praise his holy name. I love you all, brothers and sisters. I love you all. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.